back in the day, you used to always work at the
Thank you very much, Ian. This is a very special ceremony, as Ian has described, and it's to ensure our students, our footballers, the very best of luck in their games this week. Introducing our first team, our neighbours, all the way from ACT, please welcome Australian Capital Territory Boys and Girls Team. The ACT Boys and Girls Teams are represented by a squad of 16 players each, and have been selected from the National Premier League. The competition, run by Capital Football, is the highest competition offered in men's and women's football in the ACT. It showcases the elite players in Canberra and the surrounding region in a highly competitive league. Both squads have had a targeted training schedule in the lead up to these championships and contain a number of players who represented the ACT last year. The under 18 girls team is coached by Tom Crosley, and the under 16 boys team is coached by Ahmed Bagul. Please give it up for Australian Capital Territory. Introducing our neighbours north of the border, Queensland. Queensland, beautiful one day, football the next. Queensland as a sporting state is divided into 10 regions, from the five in the southeast corner and up to Cairns in the north, as far west as Mount Isa and everywhere in between. Our teams are selected from their individual age state championships held earlier in the year, and the state teams assemble for a 3-day training camp prior to the championship. This year, players come from 8 of the 10 regions, with representatives from the New South Wales border, on the Gold Coast, all the way to an hour north of Cairns. At the National Championships in Caboolture in 2019, the girls' team finished fourth and the boys' team third. Please put your hands together for Queensland. South Australia girls and boys, together with their respective officials, are looking forward to these championships with great excitement, eagerness, anticipation and expectation. Both squads are quietly confident of producing competitive football throughout the week, sprinkled with skill, challenges and individual creativity. South Australia has a blend of enthusiastic players at different stages of football development and see this championship as a key stepping stone transitioning forward. Led by dedicated and committed officials, their teams are looking forward to a most memorable, challenging and rewarding week, whereby football skills are tested, extended and further refined. Sportsmanship is highlighted, new friends are made, and everyone has a thrilling week. We are grateful for the opportunity to participate in the school's national championships and shall endeavour to showcase their positive sporting attributes in the best position in school sport Australia. Please welcome South Australia.
Please say New South Wales.
I could please ask you to stand for the national anthem. On behalf of New South Wales Combined High School Sports Association, I would like to welcome you to Glenwood and the home of football in New South Wales. Hopefully throughout the week you'll enjoy some fantastic facilities and some fantastic football, as well as enjoying some of the sites that we have in beautiful Sydney to showcase. Especially on Wednesday, our players will be treated to an educational excursion at the new Sydney Zoo. Many of you may have seen some information regarding this already, and we hope that you will enjoy your time if you decide to attend with your child. Can I first of all please introduce our championship personnel and thank them for their attendance at this morning's opening ceremony. Introducing the championship convener, Mr. Scott Belgrave from Mosley Park High School. Our grounds and facilities manager, Stephen Ross from Maitland-Burton High School. Our referee coordinator, Mr. Brendan Fotheringham from Five Island College. And Mr. Ron Smith, our social media and results coordinator. Thank you, gentlemen, for your attendance today at our opening ceremony. I would now like to call on the 2019 winning team captain to come forward and present the trophy to Mr. Scott Belgrave on behalf of Mr. Ron Pratt, who unfortunately could not be with us this morning. So we need the team captain from New South Wales. If you could pick those trophies up and present them to Mr. Belgrave, we know that's going to be hard for you to give those back, but you will need to. Thank you. This now acknowledges that the trophies are up for grabs and are any team to win. I will now please ask that Amy Hall and Aidan Green come forward and read the student pledge on behalf of all players for the championship.
On behalf of all the participants at the 2022 School Sport Australia, employees, 18 years and under girls,
our team is taught to cooperate with officials, to respect and abide by the rules that govern these championships and the best traditions of the sport, and above all, to enjoy it.
Thank you, Amy. Very important words, and let's hope that we're all listened very attentively to by all our players here. May I now thank all our invited guests, our players, our team officials, and of course our parents and spectators for your attendance. We are hoping that this week we will be blessed with some beautiful days and some beautiful football. On behalf of New South Wales Combined High School, I officially declare the School Sport Australia Football Championship for 2022 open. Thank you to our team, and if we could have you commencing with New South Wales marching off the same way when you marched on, with all our teams following. And as our teams leave the arena, please give them a big round of applause to wish them the very best of luck this week. All days of the competition.